Alright, guys, let's take up this little buggy problem. Okay. So first what you do is you unlock the trunk, and immediately afterwards, you feed it meat. Because that's totally intuitive. Alright, now what's in here? Oh! Nice music. A skeleton lies in the trunk, its bones picked clean by the dermisted beetles. They've efficiently removed every last shred of flesh, making the skeleton nearly impossible to identify.
I guess they didn't have DNA testing in the 20s yet.
You have no reason or the slightest desire to touch a skeleton.
For DNA testing to be efficient, you need the DNA of the person.
Yeah, but you could use the teeth. Although I don't know what kind of testing that is.
Yeah, but then there need to be records of that person.
True. So we don't have the slightest desire to touch a skeleton, but we're okay with poking dead people's eyeballs and heads, and yeah, that makes sense.
Well, they are more squishy.
Ooh, what's this? It appears to be a gold pocket watch. No kidding.
It has a time on it.
A close look reveals an inscription on the watch. To Dr. Archibald Carrington III, for your many years of dedicated service, many thanks from your staff at the British Museum. Oh, same thing. Well, we can take that. But why is Dr. Carrington's watch inside the trunk? That sounds very suspicious.
I find it amusing that the trunk opening and closing sounds are exactly the same sound effects used for car doors opening and closing in Police Quest 3.
Yeah. Aw, dang it. Anyone in here? Oh. This jolly scene again.
Hi, folks.
Am I going to have to spank you? I'm Squay.
Spank me? Maybe she is wanting to join us, yes? Yeah, good idea.
Sorry, I was so compelled by that picture, you know.
Okay. I think if we walk out here, we might get more muffled voices. Yes! You lied to me!
Well, lass, I guess that makes us even. You lied to me.
You had something to do with the dagger burglary.
You've been sleeping with someone else. I saw you go off with that dock worker.
I think the dock worker's the last of your worries, man. I never slept with Steve, and the Ziggy fellow, he told me about you and the dagger.
And you believed that little weasel? I've arrested the man more times than I can count.
Ziggy, I know him a long time. He would not lie to me.
That man would lie to his own mother if someone paid him for it.
Ziggy, he says you are working with the Carrington to steal the dagger.
Lies, you can't be trusting the man. If he wasn't already dead, I'd pound the truth out of him.
Well, that's not going to make you any more credible. Maybe you already did.
Were you sleeping with the little rat, then?
Of course not.
You really surprised me, lass. I'd think you grew up on the streets accusing me of burglary like that.
Where I grew up doesn't matter, does it? The important thing is... Wait, did you hear something at the door?
Yeah, I was hearing it too. Keep your voice down, then.
What were you doing, Laura? Come on. Oh, store's locked. Fine. Okay. Oh, hey, what do you know? Just randomly works. Okay. Let's take care of the little lighting problem here. Yay! Passage number 2 discovered. Yeah, so if you go down that passageway, you end up here. Although if you go back here, for some reason, you... I don't know. Can't find your way back. Ah, fine. This door's locked. Anyone in here? No? I want to go back upstairs this way. But maybe the game won't let me...
What?
Hello.
Apparently the game has decided that something is going on when it's
cool.
Not.
Yeah, we'll be right back, guys.
Oh boy.
Okay, not really sure what happened there in the office, but I'm not gonna go back in there again for now.
Wolf is so manly that just his office makes the game lock up.
I guess so. Revenge of Wolf Heimlich for us viewing his privacy. Ooh! Ooh, there is something we can do here. Now that we have wire cutters, we can get a piece of wire. A piece of wire. Oh, come on. Let me... Okay, there we go. This game is very buggy today. Yay. Now I have wire. Now I can strangle someone with it. Fun times all around. Okay, now I think there's a meeting... Yes, at 2 o'clock. Look, someone's hand has already emerged.
It's a disembodied hand.
Yay! Kick the air! Kick the air! Kick the armor! Kick us! Kick the dog!
Why you kick my dog?
Wolfie, your facial scars are so wonderful! How did you get them?
Fencing, my studio. As a young man, I would fence with my Heidelberg friends. We would stop our opponent's saber just before it went through our faces. Which would make the scars, see now.
Ah, that is very interesting. Did you not use the masks to protect your faces?
Nein, that would have been considerably unmanly.
You'll have to show me how to do that sometime.
There are many things I can show you, my strudel.
Perhaps we should go somewhere less public, Wolfie?
Oh yeah, good idea. Particularly since there is that annoying reporter wandering around the museum. It is not something I would have allowed if I was running things here.
Give it time, Wolfie. Perhaps you will be running things here someday, if I have anything to say about it.
Oh, what can you do?
There are ways. But come, let us speak of these things in more privacy.
He's kicking her. Like, move.
He's kicking her forward. Go faster.
Oh, like Germans it. Running things.
I don't really understand. If they need to... Apparently they're going to come here for this big meeting, and then they're like, no, let's go somewhere else, like, within a few seconds. Anyway. Hang on. I want to talk to you, Olympia.
Ah, he's the odd little fellow who lost his head, yes? He must have been very unlucky to have been walking under that pterodactyl at the moment it broke loose from its mount on the ceiling. Imagine being the only human ever to die from a pterodactyl bite.
Yes, very interesting. About Dr. Carter.
I think Dr. Carter is quite fortunate to have crossed into the underworld. Now he can finally meet Amun-Ra in person. I'm sure if he had the choice, Dr. Carter would have wanted to die the way he did. In a way, it sums up his entire archaeological career.
Let's see what else. Tell me about Wolf Heimlich. Oh, fine. Carrington?
Poor Dr. Carrington. He certainly had an interesting death, didn't he? I hope I expire in an equally unique fashion when my time comes. Or maybe it will come. She'll probably die smiling. Be like, yes, yes, threw my guts all over the place. I find Yvette to be a charming young lady. Some people around here don't appreciate her zest for life, but I find her quite refreshing.
Oh, hang on. Just want to do one more. Just really quickly. Oh, Steve
Dorian.
Ah, the young Steve Dorian. He's a charming young fellow. I imagine he has some wonderful scars from working on the docks. Okay, I have to cut the video right now. Bye-bye.